Good morning, everybody. Myself Vishwendra, I am the founder of Optimal Success Trajectory. Today I will talk to you about the quality of our students as per media reports. Days ago, I came through one of the website and I saw a statement of Mr. Narayana Murthy, in which he said that about 85% of the youth are not employable. Reason he told was that they have weak problem solving skills. So from there I thought to start something to train students for having problem solving skills, and because of which I started Optimal Success Trajectory with the vision to provide quality training to the students for developing problem solving skills, photographic memory, professional attitude, good EQ, good IQ, and all other skills needed to be successful in today's dynamic world. So related to that, I would like to share my experience. Every year, nearly 20 lakh students appear for engineering and medical exams, but out of which only a few are selected. The reason being that most of the students have weak problem solving skills and weak memory. They forget what they studied when they appear for the test. They are mentally weak. They are not able to bear the pressure of the exam because of weak training programs. So I aspire to provide you the training programs for photographic memory and good problem solving skills. So let us discuss about some of the qualities, some of the skills which are needed to crack these exams. Because without these qualities, it's not possible to crack your exam. It's just like putting the cart before the horse. Let's discuss about that. So the first thing which is related to the quality of working is a sharp problem solving skill. Whenever you see a problem, the natural inclination of the human mind is a feeling of anxiety, depression, lack of decision making, and a state of illusion. So the first thing that you need to have is a very sharp problem solving skills. Whenever you see a problem, within fraction of seconds, you must be able to judge the source of problem and the mechanism by virtue of which you will solve the problem. Otherwise, you won't be able to solve the problem effectively. The next thing is a sharp memory. Because to solve problems, you need to use certain information. And if your mind is not able to give you the desired information as and when needed, then it is of no use. You want to be able to solve that problem. So you must need to have sharp memory for that, as per the problem solving is concerned. Third thing is high EQ. EQ is emotional quotient. If you are easily depressed, somebody said you something and because of which you become frustrated and negative, then you need to work on your EQ, which is emotional quotient. Because if you are so timid that anybody can make you lose your patience and can control your mind so easily, then it's better to work on your EQ, emotional quotient. Be internally strong so that nobody can deviate you. Next thing is high IQ. IQ means intelligence quotient. You just need to have that for, you know, it's also part of the problem solving skill, your capacity to understand the situation and choose the right steps. The next thing is creativity. Sometimes you need to design something, you know. For that you need to have creativity. And last but not the least is the neural coordination. Because problem solving skill is just about how your neurons, how your neural network works in a certain specific condition. So better the neural coordination, better you will be able to solve your problem. I think you got the idea regarding the basic mechanism that is needed for having quality of mind. So I think if you do possess these quality of minds, then it's not possible that you won't succeed in your exam. Thank you and have a nice day.